Hey everyone, welcome to today's video. So in this video, today we are talking about that Collab AI. So we already know that Google Colab have your own Collab sheet, actually that Python sheets. So in that we can easily to edit the code and run the code and anything we can play around that with that Collab sheet actually. So in that they given that one free GPIs and the GPUs, and in that we can use it as well. So in that the limited preview access, so the Google given that all the developers, so that called Colab AI. So in that we can explore that end to end. So we can start with a very simple program too. We can start with a very advanced program to end with that advanced program as well actually. So in that I can just open that generative AI, that just Python script, just Python notebook with that Colab. So in that I can just connect it with that my RAM. So as I just my free version only, and can close it. So here's the Colab AI is there. So in that you can generate your prompt over there and also start coding or generate with the AI. So there is a option is there. So in that I can just simply open that, and in that I can just type simple hello world program in Python. So if I just enter that, so automatically that simple hello world program in Python for the prompt comment, and here's the thing. So if I run that, it will be working as we expected anyways actually. So this one, and the next thing is, so I can just go with some little bit advanced, like all right, so generative AI. So in that provide simple factorial program in Python. So if I enter that, so within the second I'm getting those results actually. So prompt provide a simple factorial, and in that n is equal to 0 1, otherwise it will be continuously doing that actually. So if I run that, as a 5 value of 120 actually. So it's crazy, right? So each time it will be giving that 4 results. So any of the results you can take it, and based on your requirements actually. And the next thing, I can again create a code, and in that I can again click the generative AI. So in that I'm gonna type provide like another some school example Fibonacci series program in Python. Yeah, we don't need that mention to Python, so just for information only I just mentioning it actually. So here's the thing, so that provide Fibonacci series program in Python, it is generating that function and it will creating a loop and calling the function twice actually. So if I run that, it is the thing 1 2 3 5 8 13 21 34 like that actually. That's pretty crazy, right? So this AI will it support more codes to developers actually. So it will be saving a lot of time actually. The same thing already ChatGPT were doing, but just for experiment purpose, we just comparing with ChatGPT as well. So simple CSV handling program. I just type the next program, Python. So if I run that, so automatically it just opening, and it will be just starting the writer and writing with the age, name John, Mary, and age 30 25. After that it just reading and writing, so that two things it doing, and that other results, so it will be just opening and reading same as. So that first results are quite crazy. Yeah, and the next thing, so I can just open that new code that generate. So I can put some complicated thing actually. So I have here a list of files, so that files it's in the single folder, so I need to read all the files under the folder actually. So I can type read the all the files inside the folder actually. So just little bit read all the CSV files inside the folder. So if I run that, see automatically that using the Colab it will be getting that CSV under that file name, it will be continuously reading and just read the file actually. So that is quite decent actually. So based on that your folder name, it will be just returning that actually. Yeah, and the next thing, so I can just go with that next program. I'm going to type create sample CSV file using pandas data frame. So this is some intermediate level program. So I can just enter it. As you can see that import pandas pd and that pd data frame in that same name, age, and after that 2 CSV. It's very simple and it looks neat and clean as well actually. See, the fourth should be a different one. They're creating as a dictionary and put it in the data frame, and they're exporting as a CSV from the data frame. Wow, it's great actually, simply great. And the next thing, I'm going with that some machine learning program actually. Provide simple machine learning program. So I can just put some overall, just simple machine learning program. So in that, oh wow, it's returning that some linear model thing is actually. So he is in that scikit-learn along with that linear model. In that linear regression, they taken that model and they created that fit for the model XY, and the model prediction should be a X test. But this XY value is not given and X test value not given, and the mean squared error, auto score, it will be just returning that. So this is the first thing, and this is the second one. So it just, okay, the second one is great actually. So getting the iris data set, and from the iris data set, it will getting the data and the target and target size, and it running to the logistic regression as well. So if I run that anyway, so in that model.fit, x train, y train, and the score also, it will be returning that accuracy as well. So it will be returning that, it will be creating a one simple linear regression model, and from the linear regression model, it loading the iris data set, and from that, it will be predicting that accuracy score as well actually. So it's decent actually. And also, as you can see that this code suggested from the license. So they already written some of the developers. So it will be taking the code from the suggestion. And based on that other thing, it will be returning actually, because they given that some open license. So that's why that code also will take actually. So this is the main difference between that ChatGPT and Collab AI. So the Collab AI will take the real-time codes from the another developers based on the license, and it will be returning to us actually. But ChatGPT will generate from that, from the model as well actually. All right, so I can take that second thing, I can prefer it actually. And the next thing, so I can click that generative AI. So in that, I'm gonna just type simple deep learning program. So now it's returning the machine learning program, right? Now we will see the deep learning program, how it is handled actually. In Python, not C++, so simple deep learning program. So within the second, it will be returning that some deep learning programs. So same as it's using the TensorFlow as well, and in that it loading the same iris data set, and in that it will be doing the test, try and split along with that same target which we get the previous thing. And after that, it just creating a own deep learning model with the Relo and a softmax, and after that it compiling the model with some algorithm, sparse categorical algorithm, and after that optimization should be added, and it training the model with 100 approach, and after that just evaluating that model actually. So this just looks like quite decent. If I run that, we'll see if that program is properly running or not actually. Wow, it's compiling that model, and the model also creating it. So after that, it'll be returning that prediction and other accuracy as well actually. Yeah, so that evaluation should be 100, that means the one, and the prediction should be a great actually. So this is crazy. So within the second, we can able to generate that models actually. So we have a multiple results. Wow. So I can go with that next thing. Click the generative AI. So in that, provide sample text-based model creation using Python machine learning. Provide text-based model, same as that thing, but if we mention that particularly text-based model, that output should be a differ actually. So the scikit-learn, that feature extraction and linear model and a pipeline they are using, and in that they just reading this data at CSV and creating a vectorizer, and that's creating a logistic regression model, and the both thing they are put it in that pipeline, and the pipeline should be a fit. And after that pipeline, they will evaluate as a model actually. So this is also quite decent. And then I'm going with the next thing. So in that sample chatbot application using machine learning. So if I run that, as you mentioned that generative is limited time for the unsubscribed users as well. Yeah. So here's the thing, just simple chatbot application without thing actually, just input random, sure, what you do, like some predefined responses they put it, and that generative response, that randomly it will be returning that response actually. Wow, It's great. So if I run that, okay. So all right, it will have the error. So if I go to that next thing, and simple machine learning using the torch and NLTK. So they are using that actually. So they have your own dataset intents.json. So based on that our input, it will be creating that chatbot program as well actually. Wow. All right. So, all right. Okay. So just for decent approach, it will be given actually. And the next thing, I can go to the next part from the generative AI. So now we can just randomly search, provide sample Flask server application for book management. So if I run that, this is for some real-time example like that. All right, so it is using that some ORM, SQL Alchemy, along with that some Flask, and in that, wow, API books, and based on that books, it will be get the books, and create the books, and update the books, delete the books as well. Wow, crazy, crazy, it's very crazy, yeah. Yeah, this is also some decent output with that Collab AI, because that Collab AI, I can always prefer that, because it will be getting that code from that real-time users actually, that open licensed users actually. So this is the thing I want to share with you guys. So hope you guys, you really like that video. And if you really like that video, please subscribe my channel for more videos like this in the future. Also, don't forget to share my video to your friends and colleagues who might find it useful. And if you have any queries or queries, so you can leave them in the comment section below. I am happy to respond, and we'll see you on the next video. Thank you. Bye.